Honorable Chris Azubugo.
Thank you, the Right Honorable Speaker. My respected colleagues, I am Honorable Chris Emeka Azubog. I present the good people of Nnewi North, Nnewi South, and the Okusigo Federal Constituency. And from Anambra State, Mr. Speaker, once more, I want to thank you for bringing to fore for debate on this respected House the issue of education. The truth is that as a nation, we will speak truth to power. We will look at it critically from perspective of ensuring what's needed to be done that was not done. We are trying to seek for solution. We've all agreed that there's a problem. When my colleague was going through the motion, and when Mr. Speaker was talking, he made it very clear that we are looking for a solution, which involves having the right content, the quality of education, teachers that are properly remunerated and motivated. But when we look at the structure, are there three critical infrastructure that is not on ground for us to plan? Because everything starts from planning. So we must have a national policy that will ensure that we provide quality education at the right quantity, to the right number. First and foremost, I believe that it is proper for us as a nation to establish a national infrastructure that will determine actually how many children do we have. It's important. Our population data, I can say that is not very reliable for proper planning. The figure that is mentioned, by all intents, I can reliably say that I will challenge that figure, that we have much more than 13.2 million children out of school. Because the data we are using from MBS is not reliable. Just days back, we developed on this on the need to ensure that there is compulsory registration of death and birth, which, if done in every local government, will allow every local government to pass to the Registrar General of Nigerian Population Commission the number of children that we have and the number of deaths that we have, so that we can plan properly and know where the demographies are. It is important that we have the reliable data to work today. We are in a scientific era where database is used for every planning and every purpose. We must have the right number, the right identity, the proper demography, so that during planning, you will allocate the number of teachers that are needed in a particular place for the particular subject, so that we will have comprehensive data. This critical infrastructure is what is needed for the basic planning. What I mentioned is that I will not talk for every other state, but I am focusing more on providing the national infrastructure that will have planning. Education is on concurrent list. You can plan from states, you can plan from regions, you can plan, but you can work from a point of view of trying to decentralize. But you must have a national policy, you must have national database, you must plan from center, so that the policy that will guide our educational content will be there. We have to work on numeracy, general literacy, and everything, so that we will even drive technology. Why are we talking about education? For economic development, for social development, you must have a properly educated and well-equipped and well-skilled citizens. We cannot have an economy because we are driving today knowledge-based economy. And how do you do that? The fundamentals of that is hinged on education, proper education, quality education. The quality of the content of education is very important. So when we want to plan for our citizens, it is proper that we have the right data, put the right infrastructure, which we manage from having the right population census, right demographic, and with that, the plans we are going to make will be sustainable. And with that, we will know, do we have the number of teachers that will match the number of children that will go?
Honorable Chris, the clerk has just alerted me. Please round up.
Okay, pupil teacher ratio. I want to conclude here that it is important that we focus on providing a national infrastructure that will cater for proper planning and for us to do reliably provide the needed manpower that is required for educational development. Thank you, Mr. Speaker.
Honorable Kiruka.